Hi, let me show you one of Moodle 2's neat tricks. In the front page here of Moodle, you've got these blocks on the side here, and they're actually called blocks. There's nothing tricky about that. And you can see we've got one for navigation, one for settings, here's another one for course categories, and so on. And the blocks live here in this menu bar on the side of the page. But what you can do in Moodle 2 that you couldn't do in Moodle 1 was this little button on the side here that says move this to the dock. Now, where's the dock? Well, the dock simply is the side of the page over here. So if I click that button, what it does is it instantly throws that navigation block over onto the side of the page, and it stays there. And I can still access it if I click on it. You can see I can bring up the same things that I had in the navigation. If I click on settings here, I can move that to the dock as well. So let's throw that up there. There it is there. There's settings. I can throw course categories up there. In fact, I can throw any of these blocks up into the side of the page here, and I can still access all their settings. Well, why is that important? Why would that be useful? Let me show you. Let's actually go into a course. Before I do that, I'll show you how to put them back. There's an undock all button here, and if I click that, it throws them all back to their proper positions on the page. All right, so click that to throw it over there. Click that button to throw it back again. We can kind of rearrange parts of our page. That's cool, but so what? Let me show you why it's useful. Let me just go into a course here. I'll pause this video while I find one. Okay, so here's the Year 9 Commerce course, and you might have seen this from a previous video where we created this course. We imported it in from the old Moodle. And one of the problems, it's not really a big problem, but it's a problem, is that this graphic is too wide. So you can see I can have to scroll sideways in order to see it. Not a big deal, but it would be nice if it worked properly. Well, if I take these blocks over here and I throw them over to the dock on the side, it actually frees up enough space on the page that I can now see the entire graphic. Well, that's one minor problem solved, but here's the real major advantage of this, is when I scroll this page, the navigation and settings blocks that are docked to the side of the page don't change. So as I scroll up and down, I can still, I don't lose these. They stay visible all the time. Under the old way of doing it, when those blocks were docked, I'll just show you, when they were in their normal position, if I scroll the page, they disappear off the top of the page there, and I can't get to them anymore. Whereas if they're docked, they stay there. Now, this docking is a per-user behavior. That means if I turn it on for me and you don't, we each see it the way we want to see it. It's not like when I change it, it changes for you. So it's per-user. So you can actually come in here and set this up any way you like. I'm just hitting the ones on the side of the page there. I've docked everything there now. That means I can scroll up and down this page. I can get the full width of the available space here if I want to, but I can still access all of the different block sections here if I want to, and they don't get lost as I scroll up and down the page. So there's some pretty compelling reasons there to have a good close look at the way blocks can be docked to the side of the page.